Hey YouTube, welcome back. I'm going to be completing my second Atlas O double track truss bridge. These kits are no longer offered. You can get an alternative where you buy the single kit bridge and then add the expansion to make it the double. But the kits that I bought were the originally no longer offered Atlas O double track truss bridges. And I'm going to show you how to assemble them, and I'm sure it works the exact same way with the single track and the single track add-on kit. So I've already gone ahead and added in the pegs and screws that you receive with this bridge, and there are 12 of them. They go in every little spot you see on the side, connects. This entire side of the truss comes pre-assembled. So does this entire side come pre-assembled. All you have to do with the glue is add on these pieces you see in front of you. And as overwhelming as it may seem to some of you more inexperienced model builders, this one here is the first model that I have built in a very long time. So, first thing you're gonna wanna do is get yourself some glue. I'm using Gorilla Super Glue. It works great. If you get too much on though, it does dry clear, so it's noticeable. But it's very, very simple to not do such. I open the bottle up like this. Oh, this is still stuck to the paper from the last time I used it. That's all right. I then get a toothpick of some sort. But the first thing it's best to do is test fit all your pieces you're gonna add. So the first ones you'll need after you get the bridge assembled up until this point here are these two. They look different from the other three that are as large as them, as they have these add-ons right here. When you're assembling these kits, I've read it's very good to test fit everything. And then you know if it's gonna fit properly or if you have to make small corrections. Typically, if you have to make a correction, something's not going right on your assembly line. That's the wrong one. These bridges have sat unassembled on my layout for years. Now that I'm finally finishing the scenery, I thought it was a good time to add these finer details in, ones that would get broken a lot easier should these bridges have had to been moved. But now that I found them forever home, they no longer have to be moved. Now these ones here go on in a unique way. There's a mounting point here, here, and here. And if you look closely at them, you have a hole on each bottom framework here, and you have a slot up here. But when you mount them, you have to mount them in a twisting motion like this. Otherwise, nothing will line up. You just want to feel that they lock in. Check that the little holes on the bottom of these tabs mount up. Expect the other ones to snap out too. They are not attached yet. All right, everything fits. Now for the glue. What I recommend is you do one side at a time. So, make sure you got some on there. Pull it off. And I'll get in here so you guys can see just how much I attach. You might want to have some old flyers below this here to catch anything that spills. And when you're assembling this here, you'll feel it when it snaps into place. Now that you have those in, I left these two hanging right here. You don't want to apply the glue sitting like that. You'll want to pull it in just a little. Give that a few seconds to dry. Now, I learned when I assembled the first one, this little tab might hang up a little bit sometimes. Not to worry. There's caps for that there. Don't try to press this down should it not fit. You'll end up with a mess of glue there. Now, if you're like me and you're just gonna paint over top of it and make it all look rusty, you're good to go. But if should you want to get that off, I'm sure there's a product that you'll need to get that off of plastic without melting through it. I'm sure there's also a proper glue for assembling these, not Gorilla Super Glue. But I buy what's local to me. Up here in Canada, we don't have big hobby shops. We do, but not in Eastern Canada where I am. Then we're going to go over to this one. I know some of you are probably thinking too, well, if you're going to weather it, why not tape it up now and do it? That's because I've never rust weathered anything in my life before, and I'm not going to let my first attempt be on something like this. So I'm probably going to be having it running a little bit more before I get to weathering it and try on some old 027 cars or some Rail King cars, something like that. Alright, now that those are in, make sure we check everything. See, this one here didn't go in. There we go. There's a better one to build some balls to. I'm right into the old country right now. So these ones here, once again, you can see where they have a tab here, which is a dot, but a tab here, which is an insert, and same with down here, which is a dot as well. Now, that the dot, I mean a female end, And the male ends are on two prongs on the side of the bridge here. So when it comes to gluing these, once again, I do it one side only. So what I do is I get a little bit of glue right here, and then I glue on the bridge itself. Then remember, you're coming in with a twisting motion. Make sure you align it into the spot on the other one, on the other side. And then you just gotta play with it a little bit. It has to be bang on to go in. Now, same thing on this side. Not a little bit too much there, but that's all right. No one will ever notice that. I know some people will be out there making sure they got it all off. Not me. You don't see that stuff on the inside. Just make sure we got a good connection everywhere. You want to hear that top, the top part of it insert. I like to let it sit for 10 or 20 seconds after before I touch the next one too. Or maybe even go to the farthest one. That wasn't supposed to happen. Come on. Let that sit for a few minutes. A few seconds, I mean.
Money makes the world go round. Around. Same old problems, same old story on repeat. What if we could make the world go forward? What if we could make our system more open, inclusive, and transparent? What if we could do for finance what the internet did for information? Crypto makes the world go forward. Crack it. See what crypto can be.
Put it on this side here because the tube is getting empty. That's why I have a second one with me.
Thank you.
There. Now, we have to assemble the interlaying work. Oh. I hope you guys can see that. So, the pieces we're going to need to assemble the interlaying work that goes here are two of these, the joiner tabs. We'll also need two of the small pieces, one of the long pieces, and some glue. So when you're doing these here, you want to identify two things. One, that you have both of these tabs here on the same side, and two, that you have them on the outside. So in order to begin, what I do, I put them both upside down. A little dab of glue. A little dab of glue. And the best part about these is there's a little channel, so you'll have them truly straight every time. And then just flip it over. That's not straight. It's not level, I mean. Now, this is important. Make sure that these are facing up, and on your straight pieces, they are facing up as well. If not, you will not get this back apart. You will have to cheat somehow to attach this. If you're wondering how I know, I know a guy. I put way too much on there, but that's okay. Hold that in there for a second. Now, just like it says in the manual, these are, oh, nope. We're showing you something too quick. There we go. So we are together on the bottom, together on the top, yes. So these are free floating. That's why it didn't look right. See, now it does. So you'll build four of these and each one will go in here. And when I get done the fourth one, I'll show you how to attach these. So now that we're done with that, we're just gonna put that out of the way. It helps sometimes too to put the two straight pieces onto the joiner plate. That can be difficult at times. Now, once again, you want to make sure that you identify these tabs. If not, like I said, y'all have to cheat to attach them. It's not hard to do, providing you do it on the far side ones. But should it be for the inside ones, you're going to have to use a vise or use a very fast drying glue and hold it in place. up. We'll put a dab on there. A dab on there. See, we're already halfway done. Those are our top cap plates I talked about. The rail joiners don't come in a bag like this. I had opened this kit long ago just to get these two pieces out and visualize it in my mind what it would look like. It got me that fix, yes. I did get my fix. Joiner pads. Oh, and put them somewhere. Oh, right in front of me. So pull these two off the kit. If you're fussy, you can cut that there off or sand it off. I just pick it off. So once again, we're identifying the top pieces, identifying the bottom. Thankfully, this bottle of glue is not very full or it would be all over the table. Oh. Put the glue on the top of one. Ooh, it's alright. It's pretty quick. Shoot. That wasn't supposed to happen. She said, I'm no quitter, but I finally quit living on dreams. I'm hungry for laughter and here ever after. Make sure if you screw up like I did, you gotta make sure everything's realigned. Don't panic. Oh, that's why I didn't put glue on one. I put glue on all of them. I remember when I reopened the box for these after probably having them stored now, a lot stored, but just not assembled for about 8 years. They kind of overwhelmed me when I seen all these pieces. There we go. See? And like I said, these cross joiner plates have a small lip on them that help align them straight. Because when I assembled the one behind you, I was rulering them all until one day I felt, or until one of them I felt it fall into a channel and realized there's a channel there. But let's quit playing with it and let it dry. By the way, if when you're doing this, you accidentally get too much glue on the cross joiner plates, wipe it up or just keep playing with it momentarily doing this until the glue dries. Otherwise, you might have to put some force on this. It could break it. It might not. But I wouldn't take the risk at the price of these bridges. One more. You took the fine time to leave me loose.
sea.
So I do the bottom side first, as you might may have noticed on every one of them. I then identify which side's up, which side's down on the joiner plate, which is very noticeable. One side has the bolts, and one side doesn't. Find somewhere to let that kind of rest. Identify the top side on the long one. Put the two male ends pointing upwards. Identifying those rivets. Alrighty. So now you can see I got some plaster on areas of my bridge I still have to wash off a little better. I got it all off the top deck, I just didn't get it off in this area. For those of you who don't follow my channel, or follow me for that matter, these two bridges are operational for a O-scale model railway, and behind them I have about 10 35 pound bags of plaster, all hand carved rock. So let's move on to attaching these and identifying what's left for pieces. So the only pieces we have left now are the underside stringers, our bridge caps, which I recommend attaching absolutely last, and the pieces that we just assembled. One we just did, it was wet still, so I'm just going to move it out of the way and give it a minute or two to dry before we think about even installing it. So the way you do this is, that one dry a little out of place to force it to break its connection. We'll fix that momentarily. You have a hole in every corner, so that's why I said it is best to keep these little nipples upside. So get your glue, and if you use a toothpick, this is where I found the toothpick comes in handy the most. So all you have to do is just poke the holes with the toothpick, and it gives them a good gob of glue. I don't recommend doing all four holes to start like I did, unless you are quick. And the best part about it, you will not need a vise to attach this. So once you get one in on, I recommend doing the long one first.
When it
tricky
comes to
get
brushing,
in there sometimes.
Like after 3 months, it's time to change. Winter is wonderful. With Starbucks,
I heard it pop.
Latte or pistachio cream,
so I like to pull up on it just a little bit. Make sure it stays where it needs to. I heard the third one pop. Now don't touch the bridge, and just give it the proper time to cure real quickly. Or like I do, move away from it. So we're just gonna stick it in each one of